Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. In this video I'm going to review Body Heat from 1981, directed by Lawrence Kasdan. And in this movie William Hurt plays this lawyer who at one night he meets Kathleen Turner's character and they start flirting and a couple of days later they meet again at a bar and they start having an affair even though she is married. And then through the film she talks about her husband that she feels afraid of him and then decides they want to kill him. And then they do that and then they becomes under investigation since there's something about the man's death that doesn't make truly sense. And especially also because she will inherit all the money of the late husband. So yeah, this film is kind of I have mixed feelings about this film because on the one hand I think it's quite good and on the other hand I think it's a bit silly and the silliness is really, you know, the predictable plot really, because this is like a typical film noir plot. You can definitely see the influence from Double Indemnity and also a little The Postman Always Rings Twice, all kinds of noirs from the 1940s, and how should I say, this film really is inspired by all these noirs from the 40s, and in some ways I admire that, in some ways it just makes it very predictable. One aspect I don't like about this film is probably the characters, because I think the characters are quite boring actually. William Hurt and Kathleen Turner's character, they play the part quite well, and it's not that I am annoyed by them, but they're so boring. I don't know why. It's like they are characters with no emotions really. You know, when they meet, they just flirt, and then they're having sexual relationships, and then they decide to kill the man or the husband, and then the last half is like them trying to figure out, or really William Hurt trying to figure out what this all about, and maybe she isn't so nice as he thought she was, and therefore the characters becomes a bit stereotypes and maybe a bit too animalistic. I don't know how I should describe them, because they really just play the film. It's difficult to really understand what the film wants to be. Is it just them having a sexual relationship, or does he really love her? I get a bit confused because I don't see the love at all. But maybe it's not meant. You don't have to think so much about that. You just have to follow the plot. But at the same time, I'm thinking he's a lawyer and he just wants to kill the husband. And I think, why? Just because he thinks she's attractive, or does he love her? I don't think it developed quite well in the first hour. The first hour is the worst part, I think. No, I do like very much John Barry's score, and that is very outstanding. That is really clearly inspired also by the 40s films, but that I really love. Really great score. It has a great atmospheric sound. And you know, for me, I think what makes the film interesting is the last half when she inherits the money, because I sort of feel like the film changes a bit, and it's really all about his perspective on her that changes, and even though you sort of see it coming, but you still feels hooked about what is really her plan. And I think the revelations towards the end about her, and there's a great twist in the end about she's probably not who she really is. She has a fake name, if that makes sense. And I like that twist. I think the twist makes the film better. And I remember also the first time that surprised me when I watched it. I thought it was quite well handled. So I think the last half makes the film better. And then you can sort of forgive its predictable plot for the most part, and also these very stereotypical characters. But again, it's not that the actors does a fine job in the role. William Hurt is always great. Catherine Turner, I think she's very great at the flirtatious part when she is that woman that is quite attractive, and you definitely feel that she is sort of a mysterious figure, maybe a type of femme fatale. But I don't think she's that convincing when she tries to play that part when she's a bit more innocent. And, oh, she loves him. She says all the time, "We have to be together." I don't think she plays that part quite well. And that's what kind of annoys me, because I think, why is he so stupid that he can't see through her? And maybe it's just the writing, or maybe it's Catherine Turner that doesn't play that aspect that well. But again, I think for the most part she's great, especially as the more ruthless parts, and when she has the flirtatious charm about her. And yeah, but it is really film made for its time, and there was a lot of these kind of noirish films in the 80s, or that was inspired by the more older films. And I do think it has great sort of homage to them, but I think that the plot could have been a bit more original. I have to admit that, because I think what it comes back to is that I just think that films from the 40s were much better written than this is. It has some great flirtatious lines in the beginning, and I also think it has a great sense of humor about it, especially when they talk about the heat. I like that idea. They always talk about the heat and the sweatiness, and you can sort of feel you feel it's very warm and hot, you know. And that's also meant to be. But again, it's not the best written film, but it's well made. Great performance by the actors for the most part, and an outstanding score by John Barry. And I do recommend this film. I do think it has a tone about it that I think is a bit mysterious. And that's all I have to say about this film. Thank you so much for watching this video, and let me know in the comments what you think of Body Heat, and I hope you will all have a very nice day. Bye.